Yan ay tutugunan ng National Maritime Council. But of course, ito si Secretary Manalo. You were referring dun sa busing incident na nangyari. Well, the National Maritime Council will consider these things, but we have to expect na ito ay continuous pattern na gagawin ng China laban sa atin. No? Ito ay continuous na struggle for presence and for assertion of sovereign rights in the area. So you will have to expect these things to happen. Hopefully, tumugon ang China sa international law at sa pangangailangan na mag-de-escalate, lalong-lalo na kung ang naratibo nila ay mali, which is mali ang sinusulong nila. So, andito si Secretary Manalo. Naturally, hindi tayo pwedeng pabayaan ito kahit na sabihin ng publiko, diplomatic protest or whatnot. We cannot not do it kung hindi nag-aakyes tayo. So, ito si Secretary Manalo.
Well, ang sabi ni Secretary ng National Defense, the National Maritime Council will meet, I understand, this week para mapag-usapan itong incident and then the appropriate response. Definitely, we will protest this latest move na coming at a time na, you know, medyo nagka-calm down ng konti, and then bigla na lang nangyari ito. The President has come out very strongly on this, and we will maintain that position.
That's something that we still have to discuss. We cannot telegraph our intentions or our moves to that.
How do you describe this behavior of
China? Consistent pattern ng behavior ng China ito. They will stick to their narrative na alam natin there is no international support whatsoever. All they have on their side is brute force, no, and strength and might, and that's what they're gonna do. Hopefully, they listen to reason and heed the appeals of not only the Philippines but other countries to temper their moves and act in accordance with international law. I do not think it's alarming. It is a response that we should need to be acclimated to.
Do you consider this as violation of climate?
Well, of course. You know why? It's a violation of the rights of Filipino fisher folk to earn a livelihood. It's a violation of the rights of the future generations of Filipinos to the sovereign rights under the extended, the exclusive economic zone, and perhaps even the continental shelf.
What does it say about China's sincerity in terms of de-escalating the tensions?
Well, China has always said it's wanted to de-escalate, but every time, of course, na may nangyayari na ganito, certainly it tends to raise tensions. So it's something that certainly we have to pay close attention to. But yun ang sinasabi nila, we'll have to see if they can really help in maintaining a more stable relationship para mag-de-escalate ng konti ang tensions. But every time something like this happens, syempre, you begin to think.
Will this affect the ongoing negotiations? Will this affect the ongoing
negotiations on
de-escalation?
And, of course, tayo, Pilipinas, we're committed, we've always said, to try and settle ang kwanong disputes or whatever through diplomatic and peaceful means. We will continue. It's up to China whether they will.
Secretary, after the BCM, parang tingin yung mga bad faith itong mga nangyayari?
Well, ang sabi ni Secretary, these things are bound to happen. Kaya that's why we talk. But certainly, sinabi ko, we've reached an understanding the other week and then mangyayari ito. So naturally, it's something we have to really consider.
Do you think it's bad faith?
Well, I don't know why they did it. You know, masabi ko, it certainly took us by surprise.
Okay, last question.
In general, just to describe ano ka delikado yung contraptive, dangerous maneuvers. Ngayon sa area na siya nangyayari.
Well, it's really very dangerous, no? Yung ginawa po nilang maneuvers na yon are very dangerous. In fact, bawal nga yung ganung kalapit at yung maglabas ng flares, no? In the path of another aircraft. That is wrong. Very dangerous, illegal po yung ginawa nilang maneuvers na yon. That is dangerous and provocative, no? Kaya't nagbilin po tayo sa ating mga piloto na huwag matakot, no? Huwag silang matakot. At itutuloy-tuloy po natin yung ginagawa nating maritime patrol in the area, because that is our right. We have been doing this for more than 3 decades already, no? Nung nawala po yung mga base militar ng mga Amerikano dito, tayo na ang naging lead sa pagpatrolya ng ating maritime and sovereign areas. No?
Sir, we see this happening a bit.
Oh, sabi nga ni Secretary Chudoro, makikita natin itong occurrence na ito in the future. So tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung gagawin nating pagpatrolya, no? At sinabihan niya natin yung mga personnel natin sa AFP na huwag matakot, no? Hindi lang po yung mga piloto, pati na rin po yung ating mga sailors ay dapat tuloy-tuloy yung ginagawa nating maritime patrol. Tuloy-tuloy lang yung schedule natin ng mga patrols in the area.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.